Hello, ladies and gentlemen, sisters and brothers. My name is Yvonne Weldon. I am a Wiradjuri woman from Cowra here in New South Wales. I'm from the waters of the Clare, also known as the Lachlan, and of the Murrumbidgee Rivers. I'm the elected chairperson of the Metropolitan Local Aboriginal Land Council, who are the cultural authority under the Aboriginal Land Rights Act for the land that I am on. I would like to pay my respects to elders past and present, to all First Nations and to you and the ancestors' lands that you are on. Welcome to country is an age-old tradition. It is more than just words, it is a spiritual process. By honouring the ancestors' footsteps, we are walking in, continuing the practice of the many generations before us to the many generations to come. The boundaries of the traditional owners are written into the earth's natural landscapes. The boundaries of the Eora are the Hawkes River in the north, the Nepean in the west, and the Georges River in the south. On behalf of the Metropolitan Local Aboriginal Land Council, the elders and the members, I welcome everyone to the land of the Gadigal. I acknowledge the Gadigal people and the many nations of people and the lands you represent online here today, whose spirits and ancestors will always remain with these lands, our Mother Earth. Across this continent, there are hundreds of nations, tribes and clans that have existed here for over 60,000 years. This country's First Nations people are the oldest living culture of the world. As we're all joined online, either through the many people of this continent or across the globe, let us all remember and acknowledge the many warriors that created pathways for all of us, the ones recognised and the ones we've never heard of. My people have always listened and learned from each other, the environment, animals, elements, and our ancestors. We don't live in isolation of body, culture, spirit, land, and water, because we are one. We need to reflect upon the footsteps we're leaving to know where we're heading, shaping a society, a country we can be proud of. In these times of this pandemic, don't let the social distance make us socially absent. We must maintain physical distancing, but not creating barriers to our social connections. So whether it's through your work or your networks, creating an inclusion, an acceptance and a resilience. We can achieve positive change each and every day towards a reconciled future, bringing my people, your people and our people together. So let us all draw upon my people's spirits as we continue on our journey. May my people's spirits walk with you and guide you as we strive forward for us all. Again, on behalf of the Metropolitan Local Aboriginal Land Council, welcome to Gadigal land. This always was, always will be Aboriginal land. Thank you and have a wonderful awards.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, special guests and Eureka Prizes finalists. Welcome all. And thank you, Yvonne Weldon, for your very warm welcome to country on this night of nights in the science world, the 30th Australian Museum Eureka Prizes Award Ceremony. I'd also like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land, the Gadigal people of the Eora Nation, and pay my respects to elders past and present on what always was and always will be Aboriginal land. Tonight is a very special evening. It's our 30th anniversary of the Eurekas, and for the first time, the Eureka Prizes is being broadcast live online due to the very extraordinary times we're living in. Joining us virtually from around the nation, COVID safely, are parliamentarians, dignitaries, trustees of the Australian Museum, prize partners and program supporters, and importantly, finalists from each of the 17 Australian Museum Eureka Prize categories. I would like to acknowledge our special guests tonight, the Honourable Karen Andrews, Minister for Industry, Science and Technology, the Honourable Melissa Price, Minister for Defence Industry, the Honourable Don Harwin MLC, New South Wales Special Minister of State, Minister for the Public Service and Employee Relations, Aboriginal Affairs and the Arts, and very importantly, our Minister. The Honourable Matthew Keane, New South Wales Minister for Energy and Environment. And the Honourable Dr. Annabel Bennett, ACSC, the Board Chair of ANSTO. Dr. Alan Finkel AO, Australia's Chief Scientist. And Australia's incoming Chief Scientist, Dr. Kathy Foley AO, currently, of course, the CSIRO's Chief Scientist. Dr. Jonica Newby, well-known TV science journalist and producer, joining us from the studio tonight. And I'd also like to welcome my colleagues from the Australian Museum, including the President of the Australian Museum Trust, David Armstrong, and Trustee Professor Merlin Crossley, who is also the Deputy Vice-Chancellor Academic at the University of New South Wales. And our newly appointed Director of the Australian Museum Research Institute and Chief Scientist, Professor Chris Helgen. We also welcome former Australian Museum President and founder of the Eureka Prizes, broadcaster Robin Williams, AOAM, who created these prizes 30 years ago. In addition to our distinguished guests, some of whom are prize presenters, we also have joining us virtually this evening from the University of Technology, Sydney, my alma mater, Professor Crate McGrath, DVC and DVP Research. From the University of New South Wales, Professor Nicholas Fisk, DVC Research. From the University of Sydney, Professor Ian Young, Dean of Science, and Dr. Carl Krulzelnicki, AM. From Macquarie University, Professor Magnus Snyden, Executive Dean of Science and Engineering. From the University of Queensland, Professor Melissa Brown, Executive Dean of Science. Now, one of our great supporters, Mr. Chris LeBlanc, is the Managing Director of 3M Australia, along with Mr. Duncan Challen, General Manager Business Development, Celestino's Sydney Science Park. Eureka Prize partners and program supporters, it is thanks to your ongoing support that the Australian Museum is able to run outstanding programs like the Eurekas. Also joining us are some of the 74 judges who gave more than 400 hours to review the hundreds of entries from every state and territory before settling on the final selection. We know it is a big and serious commitment for the judges, and we sincerely thank you. And last, but certainly not least, the 2020 Australian Museum Eureka Prizes finalists. This evening, we are celebrating 51 finalists across 17 prize categories, and they are joining us virtually from their homes and workplaces. The finalists for this year's Australian Museum Eureka Prizes embody the best scientific ideals, and their work is making a difference both at home and globally, leading us all into new areas of discovery, conservation, and economic growth. Science is at the very core of the Australian Museum. We're committed to supporting and showcasing the work of scientists who play significant roles in our nation's ongoing development, the protection of our environment and biodiversity, of the unique species who help us understand the past and inform our future. When we reopen this weekend, after 15 months of closure for major renovation, the next generations of scientists who walk through our halls will be inspired by the people like you, the Eureka Prize nominees, as well as the work being done by our scientists at the Australian Museum Research Institute. As I stand here in the new Grand Hall, surrounded by the rich history contained within these sandstone walls, I'm delighted to announce the renaming of this space as Hinsey Hall in honour of Sir Michael Hinsey, who generously donated $5 million to the Australian Museum, one of the largest donations in our almost 200-year history. Sir Michael grew up in Sydney, visiting this museum as a schoolboy, a member of our Discoverers Club. And because that early love of museums and science and recognising the inspiration they can provide, there are now two Hinsey Halls, one in London at the Natural History Museum and one here. What a fantastic gift, and I want to thank the Hinsey Family Charitable Foundation for their belief in the vision for the Australian Museum. It is now my great pleasure to welcome the Honourable Don Harwin MLC, New South Wales Special Minister of State, Aboriginal Affairs and the Arts. Minister.
2020 marks the 30th year of the Australian Museum Eureka Prizes, recognising and rewarding outstanding achievement in research and innovation, leadership in science, science engagement, and school science. Since the prizes first began in 1990, more than $4 million in prize money and a total of 416 prizes have been awarded. The Eurekas, Australia's most comprehensive national science award program, are affectionately known as the Oscars of Australian science. The prosperity of our state and country is directly linked to our ability to think big, be bold, and accelerate scientific thinking to advance. Science critically informs government policy, with science and research underpinning the growth, sustainability, and profitability of the state's industries. In this most challenging year, recognising and awarding Australian science has never been more important. I congratulate all of the finalists here tonight and look forward to celebrating with you.
Well, thank you, Kim McKay, AO, and Minister Harwin. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to this very special night, rewarding excellence in the field of research and innovation, leadership, science engagement, and school science. My name's Adam Spencer, and I'm thrilled to be your MC for the 2020 Australian Museum Eureka Prizes. And joining me tonight in the Eureka Prizes studio to offer their insights on tonight's winners are Dr. Jonica Newby, science reporter, presenter, author, and not once but twice winner of a Eureka Prize for Science Journalism, and Professor Chris Helgen, chief scientist and director of the Australian Museum Research Institute. A warm welcome to you both. Jonica, great to see you again. I always know it's Eureka's time when I see you. You're a bit of a fixture at the Eurekas.
Yes, I'm afraid it's been 20 years since I started coming to this event, but look, it is one of my absolute favourite times of the year because we get to celebrate science. And congratulations to all the finalists. I mean, I know what a big deal this is, and I really look forward to seeing who the winners are, though. So, yeah, great to be here.
Now, Chris, you've been to the Eurekas before, but you're making your sort of on-stage slash at-the-desk debut. And congratulations on the new gig. An exciting time for you at the moment.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's really great to be here, Adam.
Before we commence, I'd like to say a few words about tonight's special event. If you win tonight, a huge congratulations to you. Now, there's no stage this year from which to collect your prize, but I like to think we've gone one better. We have a live broadcast studio from the comfort and safety of their home, and joining us from around the nation are this year's finalists. So please join me in a big round of applause for tonight's superstars of science. Oh, yes. Our winners, when your name is announced, we want to see you leap from your chair or punch the air in celebration. Finally, everyone, please ensure you've downloaded the app Eventcast by Fourth Wall. You can use the app to interact with other audience members, upload photos, learn more about this year's finalists. In the app, you use the code Eureka and then log in with your email address and the unique PIN that was sent to you via email to access the discussion feature. If you can't find your app PIN, don't panic. Just click the reset password button in the login section in the app and watch out for the reminder email. If you don't have a password, just use mine, 123456 Mr. Happy, and get social. Jump online and support the Eureka Prizes throughout tonight's event. You can follow at Eureka Prizes on Twitter and just retweet or like the real-time announcements. And any socials you use tonight, please do the hashtag Eureka Prizes. But now, without further ado, let's get into tonight's festivities. For our first prize this evening, I would like to invite Professor Nicholas Fisk, Deputy Vice-Chancellor of Research from the University of New South Wales, to announce the winner of the 2020 UNSW Eureka Prize for Excellence in Interdisciplinary Scientific Research. This prize is awarded to an outstanding research outcome that was only possible as a result of the integration of two or more unrelated disciplines. But before the announcement, let's meet this year's finalists.
Professor Vanessa Hayes, Garvan Institute of Medical Research and University of Sydney. Ridge to Reef Fisheries, University of Queensland. Social Ecological Research Frontiers, James Cook University, University of Tasmania, Macquarie University, University of Technology Sydney, Australia Institute of Marine Science, Western Australia Department of Biodiversity, Conservation and Attractions, and the Nature Conservancy.
So, the winner of the 2020 UNSW Eureka Prize for Excellence in Interdisciplinary Scientific Research is, open the envelope, the Social Ecological Research Frontiers team.
Great stuff. understandably very, very happy. Congratulations. Say a few words on behalf of the massive team.
Great. Well, I'm here with team member Michelle Barnes, who also happens to be my wife. And we're joining you all from Woolgaroogaba and Bindle Country. And I just wanted to say thanks so much for the Australian Museum for recognizing the importance of interdisciplinarity, precisely because it's so undervalued by traditional or conventional academic silos. So thank you so much. It really means a lot.
Tremendous success, world-class science, and a love story. What else could you ask for our first winner of the evening, the Social Ecological Research Frontiers? And thank you very much, Professor Fisk. We'll be hearing from you again a little later in the evening. And I'd now like to welcome the Honourable Karen Andrews MP, the Minister for Industry, Science and Technology.
Well, thank you, Adam. Now, before I announce the prize winner for the Department of Industry, Science, Energy and Resources, Eureka Prize for Innovation in Citizen Science, I would really like to take the opportunity to say a huge thank you to the science community, to everyone right across Australia who has done so much to support us during this very difficult year. It's not just COVID-19, it's everything else that we've had to deal with, including the bushfires. So thank you from a very grateful nation. We really do appreciate everything that you as a science community have done for us.
Thank you, Minister. The 2020 Department of Industry, Science, Energy and Resources Eureka Prize for Innovation in Citizen Science is awarded for demonstrated excellence in citizen science practice through an innovative research and community engagement project. But before you announce the winner, Minister, let's take a look at this year's finalists.
The AstroQuest team, International Centre for Radio Astronomy Research. Team Brush Turkey, University of Sydney and Taronga Conservation Society Australia. Victorian Coastal Monitoring Program, University of Melbourne, Deakin University, Department of Environment, Land, Water and Planning, and Propeller Aerobotics.
Winner of the 2020 Department of Industry, Science, Energy and Resources Eureka Prize for Innovation in Citizen Science is Victorian Coastal Monitoring Program. Congratulations.
Great stuff. Understandably pumped, understandably very excited. Who'd like to say something on behalf of the team?
Thank you very, very much. It's just such an honour to be awarded in through here. We're actually coming from the field in rural Victoria, so hopefully the connection's okay. But thank you very much. It's such an honour. And I think the biggest thanks goes to our citizen scientists. Without our wonderful volunteers and their dedication, there's no way we'd be able to do the work and the fantastic knowledge that we're getting. It's all to our citizen scientists. So thank you very much.
Well, congratulations, deserved winners there. So I did see a little bit of love for the Brush Turkey program as well on the chat line there. Keep those thoughts coming through. Congratulations, Victorian Coastal Monitoring Program. Well, thank you, Minister Andrews, and thanks so much for staying with us as we announce the winner of the 2020 Department of Industry, Science, Energy and Resources Eureka Prize for STEM Inclusion. Now, this prize is awarded for initiative that's led to a greater inclusion in science, technology, engineering and mathematics. Let's take a look at this year's finalists.
CSIRO Indigenous STEM Education Project. Kakadu NESP Team, CSIRO, University of Western Australia, Charles Darwin University, Kakadu National Park Board and Traditional Owners, Northern Land Council, Microsoft, and National Environmental Science Program. Corey Tutt, University of Sydney.
And the winner of the 2020 Department of Industry, Science, Energy and Resources Eureka Prize for STEM Inclusion is CSIRO Indigenous STEM Education Project. Congratulations.
Congratulations, well done. Please say a few words on behalf of the project.
Thank you very much. I'm on Gurumbal Borough, Walgaroo Kabar country here up in North Queensland. The Indigenous STEM Education Project is very proud to be awarded the Australian Museum Eureka Prize for STEM Inclusion. Indigenous Australians are the world's oldest STEM professionals, and it is our honour to continue this practice, forging new education and career pathways for Aboriginal and or Torres Strait Islander students. I want to acknowledge Kathy, her team, and Corey Tutton, your wonderful work that you do. It's an honour to be in partnership with you and to see you thrive in this area. The project wouldn't be possible without the funding partnership of BHP Foundation and the support of Indigenous elders, communities, organisational partners, mentors, teachers, parents, students, and our dedicated CSIRO team. Thank you to all the leaders. Thank you to our team in CEDO and Mary Mulcahy and others. We thank you. And thank you very much for this honour. We do appreciate it. Thank you, everyone.
Well said, well said. It is a fantastic program, the CSIRO Indigenous STEM Education Project. And once again, thank you, Minister Andrews. Now, before we continue with our avalanche of winners, I'd like to invite former Australian Museum President, founder of the Eureka Prizes and science broadcaster and presenter of the ABC Science Show, Dr. Robin Williams AO, to the screens. Welcome, Robin. How are you?
Thank you, Adam. Very well.
Great to have you here, mate. Can I start by asking, the Eureka Prizes, how did they come about and where did the name come from?
Well, they came about, as you know, 30 years ago. And at that stage, we were just discovering that Australian science was fantastic, was absolutely marvellous, but the general public didn't know it because lots of prizes were held in darkened rooms with about 7.5 people there and a woman at the back. And I got many people in touch with me as president of the Australian Museum Trust saying, well, what can we do? And I said, why don't we put them all together? Because the Australian Museum was keen to do it at the time. And I know that, you know, Barry Jones had invented the Australia Prize, which had just become, after a few years, the Prime Minister's Prize for Science. But that often involved overseas people. So we put them together so that it was really big and really significant. And instead of treating science like something that went on in a back room somewhere, as something that changed lives and was all about the future and would really celebrate those scientists, men and women, in a way that made them feel special. And we had 5 prizes in the beginning, and I modelled one of them about the promotion of science on what the Royal Society of London called the Faraday Prize, after Michael Faraday, and we had a book prize and a couple of others. And so it grew from there. And okay, why call it Eureka? If you happen to be sitting in a bath in ancient Greece about 2,000 years ago and called Archimedes, and you are trying to solve a problem about the volume of certain things made of gold or silver, they were adding silver and being rather naughty about it, and you had to find the right volume. And there he was in the bath, so they said, and he noticed that as his body went in under the water, he displaced a certain amount of water that was exactly the same. And he went, Eureka! So we've got that, you know, cry of joy. And also something Australian, which is being a bit stroppy, you know, the Eureka stockade, where the workers were rebelling against the owners and various other people. So that kind of combination, it seemed to fit.
And it's now been 30 years of scientists shouting Eureka, not necessarily running naked down the streets, but shouting Eureka. What's been some of the highlights across the 30-year journey for you?
Well, finding those people who had been doing so much and recognising them, from Mike Archer, who was there at the beginning in the Australian Museum, eventually he became director, and someone called Tim Flannery might spring to mind, but lots of people who did so much work publicly, including young people, who made things work, as we'll find out. But for me, the most significant thing is the rise in the last 30 years of women. Because way back, you know, take it 75 years ago, a woman called Ruby Payne Scott helped invent radio astronomy, and she lost her job. Why? Because they found out she was married and she disappeared from history. There were lots of things about the place of women in science that were not recognised. Now, if you look at any number of prizes, including the one I'm still involved with, I mentioned Faraday Prize, well, the Promotion of Science Prize, the three finalists are women, and we could have appointed, oh, I don't know how many others who are in the running-up list who are also women. And I think that, for me, has been absolutely the highlight.
It's been a wonderful 30 years.
Yep.
Here's to the next 30 years. We couldn't have had the first 30 without you. Thank you so much, Robin Williams.
Thank you, Adam.
OK, let's get back into the prizes. I'd like to invite Dr. Karl Kruschelnitsky and Professor Ian Young from the University of Sydney to announce the runners-up and ultimately the winner of the 2020 University of Sydney Sleek Geeks Science Eureka Prize, Primary Division. Now, this prize is awarded for a short film that communicates a scientific concept in an accessible and engaging way. And this year, the students were set the topic of water. Let's meet the finalists.
Scarlett Pawson and Scarlett O'Neill, Oak Flats Primary School, New South Wales.
Well, so I didn't know you had superpowers.
It's just super cool science.
First, let's have a look at how water turns into ice.
Clara Potter, Murrabinong Primary School, Australian Capital Territory.
Would you be surprised if I told you that water acts a bit like this trampoline?
When I jump, the mat stretches
down.
And the springs boost me back up.
Nice.
Levi Swift, Norwood Primary School, Tasmania.
These are in fact droplets of water on a hot pan. These droplets fly around the pan, excitedly fueled by evaporator. This phenomena is not the Muppet Song phenomena. It's called the Leidenfrost effect.
Third place is awarded to Clara Potter.
Second place goes to Levi Swift. Congratulations on your wonderful Leidenfrost.
The winners of the 2020 University of Sydney Sleek Geeks Science Eureka Prize Primary are Scarlett Pawson and Scarlett O'Neill.
Great stuff. Tanya Crystal, please do the honours. Dr. Karl, what would you like to say to our finalists?
Congratulations to all the wonderful Scarlets in the world, the Pawson and the O'Neill. There's so many things you can do with water. Scarlett and Scarlett, why did you go for water freezing?
Would you like to answer that question, Scarlett?
What was that?
Why did you go on picking freezing rather than anything else like staining clothes or boiling?
Well, we watched lots of experiments on super cool science, and we just thought it would be really, really cool to do it ourselves.
And let me ask you another one. Did everything work the first time, or did you have to do your experiments more than once?
Definitely
more than once.
Yeah, we had to do lots of water bottles until we finally got it right.
Yeah.
You guys are fantastic. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Tremendous stuff. A huge congratulations to Scarlett Pawson and Scarlett O'Neill. Well done to the both of you, and of course to the runners-up in that category, Levi Swift and Clara Potter. As part of their prize, the winners and runners-up will receive vouchers to the wonderful Abbey's Bookshop. Thank you to David and the team at Abbey's for their always generous support. And thank you so much to Professor Young and Dr. Karl. We'll see them again soon. Wow, we are off and running. What an amazing bunch of prize winners we've seen already here tonight. Time to get some comments from my panel, I do think. Chris, some fantastic winners so far. What's leapt out for you?
Well, those kids were amazing. Yeah. Those Sleek Geeks, you have to love it. I also just want to say all the finalists for the STEM Engagement Award, absolutely tremendous. The winners, the CSIRO Indigenous STEM Education Project, you know, they talk about the oldest STEM professionals in Indigenous Australia. So true and so tremendous. The two-way engagement between Indigenous knowledge and the scientific worldview, fantastic stuff.
Well, I'm still giggling from watching those kids. I'm sorry, I actually laughed out loud, but I'm just loving the reactions that we're getting from the winners at home. I mean, those hugs, was there anything more joyous than that? And all fantastic winners, but I just want to mention, if I can say this right, the winner of the Interdisciplinary Award, because, of course, these days with wicked problems, this is what you need. You need teams from every little discipline, every big discipline, coming and putting their best ideas together. And one of the most wicked problems, of course, is coral. Coral is in serious danger. And it's fantastic to see that the research of these Australian scientists, who are amongst the many Australian scientists throwing everything they've got at this problem, it's fantastic to see this celebrated. And I actually want to congratulate every coral scientist in Australia. You guys are heroes.
You only had to see the list of teams listed as part of that award to see how truly interdisciplinary. It might have been easy to give an award to anyone watching who wasn't part of that team. It was incredible.
What a crew.
Let's have a look at what people are saying at home as well via the app. Ellie, Kirsty, Zachary and Sean are congratulating all the incredible finalists tonight, saying good luck to them all. And a lovely comment from Ewan, who says, what an amazing institution the Eurekas are. Good luck to all the fabulous scientists, science journalists and science communicators being featured tonight. They are great comments. Please keep them coming through. Thank you, Jonica. Thank you, Chris. And now, back to the prizes. Rejoining us from the Australian Museum, I'd like to welcome Kim McKay, AO, Director and CEO of the Australian Museum.
Thanks, Adam. Here I am in the Australian Museum's new 1,000 square metre touring exhibition hall, where our homegrown blockbuster Tyrannosaurs Meet the Family will open to the public this Saturday. Since leaving here 6 years ago, Tyrannosaurs has toured North America to sell out crowds and had just moved to Edinburgh when it went into lockdown at the Royal Museum of Scotland. Yes, COVID-19 has even impacted the tour of T-Rex. This past year has been an important year for science journalism here and around the world. Never before has the importance of truth and timely and clear information been more critical, whether it has been the impacts of drought and climate change or the ravages of the bushfires and, of course, the coronavirus. We have tuned in and consumed news like we haven't done in decades.
So true, Kim, so true. And the 2020 Australian Museum Eureka Prize for Science Journalism will be awarded to an Australian journalist or journalist team whose work is assessed as having most effectively communicated scientific or technological issues to the public.
Dr. Jackson Ryan, CNET. Carl Smith, Natasha Mitchell, Brendan O'Neill and Hamish Camilleri. Australian Broadcasting Corporation. Tegan Taylor, Dr. Norman Swan and Will Ockenden, Australian Broadcasting Corporation.
And now the winners of the 2020 Australian Museum Eureka Prize for Science Journalism are from ABC CoronaCast, Tegan Taylor, Dr. Norman Swan and Will Ockenden.
Great stuff we've got here, Tegan, to say a few words on behalf of the team. What would you like to say, Tegan? Been a massive year for you and the team.
Oh, we're so honoured, especially against such a tough field. And it's answering burning coronavirus questions from the audience is not a responsibility that we've taken lightly this year. I just want to say thank you so much to all of our colleagues in the ABC Science Unit, the ABC Audio Current Affairs, and a really big shout out to Widya Jalal and Narissa Aslan from ABC News Digital, who've sifted through the 100,000 plus questions that we've got from the audience this year that's really shaped the show. Thank you again, and like everyone, we're really looking forward to the day when we don't need CoronaCast anymore.
There you go, 100,000 plus questions. Congratulations to our prize winners, Tegan Taylor, Dr. Norman Swan and Will Ockenden. And thank you very much, Kim. We look forward to joining you again from the Australian Museum a little bit later in the evening. I would now like to invite Professor Kate McGrath, Deputy Vice Chancellor of Research at the University of Technology Sydney, to announce the winner of the 2020 University of Technology Sydney Eureka Prize for Outstanding Mentor of Young Researchers. This award is for an individual who's helped develop the next generation of Australia's scientific researchers.
Professor Carol Amour, AM, Wilcock Institute of Medical Research and University of Sydney. Professor Karoo Assel, University of Technology, Sydney.
And the winner of the 2020 University of Technology Sydney Eureka Prize for Outstanding Mentor of Young Researchers is Professor Carol Amour, AM.
It is such a crucial part of the broader scientific effort. Congratulations on being such an inspirational mentor, Carol. Would you like to say a few words, Carol, if we've got you there? Otherwise, I'll say, on behalf of Carol and all the people she's inspired down through the years, congratulations, Carol. We think you absolutely rock. And thank you so much, Professor McGrath. We look forward to seeing you later this evening for another prize presented by the University of Technology Sydney. I would now like to invite Professor Magnus Nudean, Executive Dean, Faculty of Science and Engineering at Macquarie University, who's joining me this evening in the studio to announce the winner of the 2020 Macquarie University Eureka Prize for Outstanding Early Career Researcher. Great to have you here, Professor. Welcome.
Thank you so much.
This prize is awarded for outstanding scientific research conducted by an individual early career researcher. Let's have a look at our finalists.
Dr. Natalie Bock, Queensland University of Technology. Dr. Lining Arnold Ju, University of Sydney. Dr. Chilin Wang, University of Technology, Sydney.
And the winner of the 2020 Macquarie University Eureka Prize for Outstanding Early Career Researcher is... Dr. Chilin Wang. Would you like to say a few words?
Yes. So I feel very pleased and honored to receive this Prize Teachers Award. I would like to thank Australian Museum and also the sponsors for this award. I would also like to thank my nominators, referees, and also UTS to strongly support me for this award. Also the Australian Research Council for their funding support. So thank you. Thank you. Have a nice evening.
Well, congratulations, Dr. Chilin Wang, and thank you, Professor. How's my Swedish? Nudean?
Perfect.
Nudean?
It's absolutely perfect.
Thank you so
I'm
much.
Impressed.
Thank you very much, Professor Nudean, for joining us. I'd now like to welcome the Honourable Matt Keane MP, the Minister for Energy and Environment, and the Member for Hornsby.
Thanks, Adam. Before I announce the winner of the New South Wales Environment, Energy and Science Eureka Prize for Applied Environmental Research, I'd like to say a few quick words. On behalf of the New South Wales Government, can I extend my sincere thanks to the scientific community for the work that you do to address our environmental challenges. I'd particularly like to extend my gratitude to the scientists who have supported the government and communities during what has been an extraordinarily challenging year, starting with the Black Summer bushfires. My own department, scientists, have been working tirelessly to understand the impacts of the fires, and have delivered new satellite mapping to show their extent and severity across the state. We are using their incredible knowledge of fire ecology to prioritise on-ground conservation activities for some of our most vulnerable species. This would just not be possible without passionate people doing world-class environmental science. I commend all of you for your dedication and thank you for your commitment to protecting our environment and building a sustainable future. You are the experts, the academics, and I am listening. Because extraordinary things can be done when government listens to science and we put our collective efforts towards finding innovative solutions.
Thank you very much, Minister. Now, the 2020 New South Wales Environment, Energy and Science Eureka Prize for Applied Environmental Research is awarded for outstanding research that has led to a practical improvement in the management or protection of Australia's natural environment, particularly challenges posed by the impacts of bushfires, climate change and greenhouse gas emissions. Let's have a look at our finalists.
Cat Ecology, Impact and Management Team, the Threatened Species Recovery Hub of the National Environmental Science Program. Rebuilding Australia's Lost Shellfish Reefs, the Nature Conservancy, James Cook University, University of Adelaide and University of Tasmania. Tackling Prey Naivety Team, University of New South Wales, Arid Recovery, University of California and Bush Heritage Australia.
The winner of the 2020 New South Wales Environment, Energy and Science Eureka Prize for Applied Environmental Research is Rebuilding Australia's Lost Shellfish Reefs.
Great stuff. Congratulations. Such important work you and the team are doing there. What would you like to say?
Thank you, Adam. Look, I'm delighted to accept this award on behalf of my colleagues, Heidi Alloway, Christine Crawford, Don McAfee and Ian McLeod. We're, of course, just a handful of scientists working right across the country to protect and restore our critical coastal ecosystems. So thank you to the Australian Museum, the New South Wales Government, and, of course, our partners, the Marine Biodiversity Hub and the Thomas Foundation, for supporting our fantastic work. Thank you.
We've already sent some love towards coral research tonight. And there you go, also Rebuilding Australia's Lost Shellfish Reefs. Congratulations. And thank you, Minister Keane, for joining us this evening. Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen. We are halfway, give or take a standard deviation, say, in this, the 30th Eureka Prize is the first ever virtual event. So as we review this next tranche of winners, I want to go to you, Jonica, as a two-time, not one-time, but two-time prize winner of the Prize for Science Journalism. Why don't you welcome the new members to this most august club?
Absolutely. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Tegan Will and, of course, living national treasure, Dr. Norman Swan. I mean, sorry, but the guy was actually born for this moment. Look, I've been an avid CoronaCast listener. I have listened every single day since March. And I've been thinking about it. The thing is that this program has this fantastic ability to give you truthful information that is sobering, but is somehow encouraging and reassuring.
And as Tegan pointed out, driven so much by the listeners, hundreds of thousands of questions that they then had to sift through, pick the best ones, the most informative ones, and then create a narrative out of that. It's incredible stuff.
It's absolutely extraordinary. And it struck me, something I've been thinking about anyway, that in a crisis, certain types of crisis, that actually the science reporter is often a better way to communicate than the news and current affairs system, because the news and current affairs is based on conflict and it tends to give you confusion and fear and anger. Whereas clear information presented by great science reporters actually gives you, tells you what is known, what isn't known, and then that certainty and uncertainty allows you to have the courage to do what you need to do. So, God, imagine if we had a Norman Swan for climate, you know, how great we'd be doing there. So congratulations, team. We owe you a debt.
What jumped out for you from that last batch of winners?
I want to give a shout out to Professor Carol R. Moore. We didn't hear much from her, but we didn't need to. The incredible statements from researchers that she has mentored, it comes through beautifully. It's a great moment for us now to celebrate the importance of women mentors. And what we've seen, you might have seen outpouring of in social media just in the last week of people celebrating key women mentors as one of the ingredients for success in science. Fantastic to see Carol recognized.
And for people who don't know about the Woolcock, it's an institute that's a sleep science institute. It's at the cutting edge of sleep and its impact on physical health, mental health, how it interacts with what we eat, what we drink and the like. A fascinating place for science.
Absolutely. Cross-cutting across so many things. Thanks, Adam.
Now, and we've had comments coming in from the audience as well. We'll take some of them. Sabina says, from a former Eureka Prize winner myself, I'd like to thank Robin Williams for establishing the Eureka Awards and recognising my contribution to research. Well said, Sabina, and well done again, you. And Penelope says, congratulations to all finalists. It's so good to see you're being rewarded for your exceptional contributions. So we'll hear more from the panel soon. Keep those comments coming. But now, back to the prizes. And I'd now like to invite Dr. Alan Finkel, Australia's chief scientist, to announce the winner of the Finkel Foundation 2020 Eureka Prize for long-form science journalism. This award is for an accurate, engaging and expertly crafted story focused on a scientific topic.
Dr. Paul Beagler, Monash University. Ceridwen Dovey.
Okay. The winner of the Finkel Foundation 2020 Eureka Prize for long-form science journalism is Ceridwen Dovey. Yay, Ceridwen.
You're looking very excited, Ceridwen, as is someone else. Why don't you say a few words?
Oh, look, thank you so much for this honour. I'd like to pay tribute to The Monthly magazine, which is a beacon of light, independence, hope and truth in the Australian media landscape, and a very special thank you to The Monthly's editor, Nick Fike, for his courage and his commitment to in-depth long-form journalism. It's really without Nick's support, encouragement and belief, this essay would never have seen the light of day. And I'd also like to give a shout out to all the other freelance science journalists out there who, like me, write their articles as a labour of love. This article emerged from my growing conviction that space environments, including our precious moon, will need to be conserved and protected as passionately as natural environments on Earth. And so I'm asking any space scientists who are listening in tonight, please join me in becoming a space environmentalist and not just letting industry as usual practices pollute the moon as we have polluted Earth. My son, Gethin, would like the last word this evening.
Please do not destroy, pollute, or mine our beautiful moon.
Thank you.
Well said, Gethin. Congratulations, Ceridwen, and thank you so much, Dr. Finkel, for joining us this evening. Joining me in the studio tonight, I'd like to invite Duncan Challen from Sydney Science Park by Celestino to announce the winner of the 2020 Celestino Eureka Prize for promoting the understanding of science. Great to have you here, Duncan.
Thanks, Adam.
Now, this prize is awarded to an individual scientist who shared their expertise with a broad audience, informing, enthusing and engaging the public. So let's meet our finalists.
Dr. Sophie Calabretto, Macquarie University. Associate Professor Alice Motion, University of Sydney. Dr. Gemma Sharp, Monash University.
And the winner of the 2020 Celestino Eureka Prize for promoting understanding of science is Associate Professor Alice Motion. Alice, would you like to say something? Congratulations.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. I'm absolutely honoured, and I'd just like to say congratulations to both Sophie and Gemma. to be a finalist with these two fantastic women is really very special. I'd like to say thank you to everybody who's done such a really important job, particularly this year, in sharing science stories and combating misinformation, both fellow academics, but also importantly, those who do this in many other spaces. I'd like to thank all of my colleagues at the University of Sydney and the School of Chemistry, and all of the many folks who I've been really lucky to collaborate with in sharing science stories with many diverse audiences. Thank you so much.
Well, congratulations, Associate Professor Alice Motion. Anyone knows Alice won't surprise you that in a room of very well-dressed people, she was far and away the most colourful person on display. And thank you so much, Duncan, for joining us.
Thank you.
I'd now like to invite Professor Melissa Brown, Executive Dean, Faculty of Science for the University of Queensland, to announce the winner of the 2020 Australian Infectious Diseases Research Centre Eureka Prize for Infectious Diseases Research. This is a prize awarded for outstanding infectious diseases research that benefits or has the potential to benefit human health. Let's meet our finalists.
Australian Paediatric Influenza Immunisation Research Group, Wesfarmers Centre of Vaccines and Infectious Diseases, Telethon Kids Institute, University of Western Australia, Western Australian Department of Health, National Centre for Immunisation Research and Surveillance, AusVac Safety Consortium, the Paediatric Active Enhanced Disease Surveillance Network, and Influenza Complications Alert Network. Professor Gregory Dorr, Kirby Institute. Team Strep A, Peter Doherty Institute for Infection and Immunity.
The winner of the 2020 Australian Infectious Diseases Research Centre Eureka Prize for Infectious Disease Research is Professor Gregory Dorr.
Congratulations, Professor Dorr. Please, say a few words.
Thanks very much, Adam. Look, I'm up as an individual, but I really wanted to thank the whole team at the Viral Hepatitis Clinical Research Program at the Kirby Institute. It's been an amazing sort of year in infectious diseases, obviously, research. And I also wanted to really acknowledge the affected communities. We do a lot of work in terms of hepatitis C treatment studies among people who inject drugs, people who are experiencing homelessness, and people who are incarcerated. Without their trust in the work that we do, we wouldn't be able to advance the field. So really, so much thanks to the affected communities around Australia. Thank you very much.
Well, congratulations, Professor Gregory Dorr. Not sure who the dude was in the beanie, but a big hello to him too. And thank you, Professor Brown. I would now like to ask Professor Nicholas Fisk to rejoin us and announce the winner of the 2020 UNSW Eureka Prize for Scientific Research. This prize is awarded for outstanding, curiosity-driven scientific research. So let's hear from our finalists.
The Australian Quantum Vortex Team, University of Queensland, Monash University and Swinburne University of Technology. Kuchiyam P. Darwish, Australian National University and Curtin University. Professor Mark Fabreo, Monash University.
Now for this one, the winner of the 2020 UNSW Eureka Prize for Scientific Research is, in the envelope, Professor Mark Fabreo.
Hugs all round, pats on the shoulders, kisses. Congratulations. Mark, say a few words.
I'm pretty lost for words, actually, because the other finalist was so good and I didn't think I'd win this. I just want to acknowledge we're in our backyard. We can't be there. I just want to acknowledge the Wurundjeri people, the traditional owners of the land. And also, you know, as I've got older as a scientist, I've reflected on all the wonderful people that have gone through my lab. This is their award. Thank you.
Well said, Mark. Congratulations, Professor Mark Fabreo. Getting a little bit emotional there. And thank you too, Professor Fisk. Let's, for the second last time this evening, rejoin our panel of Jonica and Chris. Chris, I'd love your thoughts on the winner for long-form science journalism, because Little Birdie's told me you might even know them. But before I get your thoughts on that, can I just say to the outgoing chief scientist, Alan Finkel, bloody well done you, sir. Chris, to you.
Yeah, absolutely. I was at university with the winner for long-form journalism, Karen Wendovi. And, you know, she has gone on to be quite a celebrated novelist since that time. And how exciting is it to see her pouring her energies as a writer into long-form journalism and into the piece that won tonight, thinking about space environmentalism. Mm. Oh, right, what a concept. Beautifully stated, as she said, winning there with her son there, about the importance of venues that explore fact and truth, especially now. So I also enjoyed Mark Fabreo there at the end, speaking and thanking his whole lab. That is how science is done. That was great to see that.
And was it just me? He was getting a little bit teary, wasn't he, just when he thought about the people he'd worked with across the journey?
Understandably so. Just imagining that history and all the work that goes into all those projects, that's what won.
Jonica, what's leapt out at you in the last few that we've seen?
Well, I'm actually getting a bit teary just with having all the families involved in the awards like this. It's actually really bringing home all the people behind the people in the awards.
It's the funny thing with streaming, isn't it? Because in the early days of your Zoom meeting, someone would be doing a Zoom meeting and their kid would come in the background and they'd be going, get out. And now it's quick, come in here, tell them about your project. Yeah, it's wonderful, isn't
it? You just don't want the naked bomb from your husband.
Sure. Yeah.
That never happened to me, except it did. But anyway, I would like to highlight, though, the award for the public promoting understanding of science, because that also is very dear to my heart. And Alice, fantastic winner. And full marks for the socially distanced crowd, support crowd she had. I mean, wasn't that fantastic?
Well done.
So very 2020. But also a very worthy winner, because incredible scope of things she does, from podcasts with Bernie, another well-known science communicator, to appearing at music festivals and things like this. But also she's a huge advocate for open development and discovery of drugs for, say, malaria, and helping get new drugs to developing countries which otherwise might not get the funded, pharmaceutical companies involved. So a fantastic winner.
And as Robin pointed out, Robin Williams earlier, three very talented young women at the absolute height of their game when it comes to communicating the joy of science.
Absolutely.
Wonderful stuff. Our audience at home are full of joy as well. Jonathan congratulates all the winners, especially the primary Sleek Geek winners, who he said brought the house down. And Joyce said, great to see budding scientists getting acknowledged. It inspires kids to participate in the field of science. And Jonathan Karapetis also says, I'm loving the live stream. Special shout out to Chris Blythe and the Pediatric Flu Surveillance Team, Asher Bowen and Sophie Calabretto, Family First. Well, thank you both, Jonica and Chris. More soon. Now, before we announce the winner of the Australian Museum Research Institute Medal, I'd like to ask Professor Chris Helgen to say a few words on behalf of AMRI. Chris, over to you.
Thank you, Adam. The Australian Museum Research Institute researches, communicates, and educates the public on some of today's major challenges. In June this year, I was honored to be announced as the new Chief Scientist and Director of AMRI, taking over the position from Dr. Rebecca Johnson. Like all Australians, we at AMRI have faced a challenging year with drought, bushfire, climate change, and COVID-19. AMRI researchers focused on these challenges, from looking at the impact of climate change and invasive species on Lord Howe and Norfolk Island, to helping fight the criminals responsible for the illegal international wildlife trade. We responded to bushfire recovery with citizen science. Thousands of Australians participated in our programs, such as Frog ID, en masse. In the last financial year, 201 new species were described by AMRI, with 214 papers published by our staff and honoraries. AMRI has embarked on the Collection Enhancement Project, an ambitious 10-year project to digitize and conserve our 19.5 million natural science specimens. Our citizen science projects have grown, with Digivol taking off during this global pandemic. Research at our Lizard Island Research Station has reopened, with evidence of the coral reef recovering. And our field work, although limited this year, has seen the discovery of fossil species inland and deep sea worms at sea. We are so proud of our scientists and collaborators at the Australian Museum, who significantly contribute to various scientific fields every year. However, there are select outstanding individuals who we acknowledge annually at the AM through awards such as the AMRI Medal, but also via the AMRI Lifetime Achievement Award. Although this could not be held this year, I'm thrilled to announce that we'll be holding the event next year with the recipient of the award, Dr. Val Attenborough, one of Australia's leading archaeologists.
Well, thank you, Chris. And now to announce the winner of the Australian Museum Research Institute Medal, I'd like to introduce Professor Merlin Crosley, the Deputy Vice-Chancellor of the Academic Division at the University of New South Wales and Trustee of the Australian Museum.
Thank you, Adam. Welcome. I'm not sure how many of you are familiar with Australian law, specifically New South Wales Legislation No. 95, Part 2, Item 7, Paragraph 2. For those of you who do not have it to hand, I'll read it out loud. The Australian Museum Trust shall emphasise propagating and increasing knowledge in the natural sciences of biology, anthropology, and geology. And we do. Over the years, you have witnessed Australian Museum Research Institute scientists winning awards for their work in biology, fish and fowl and koalas, etc. Or anthropology, wonderful work on First Nations people and sophisticated technologies, cultures, and trade routes. But I bet you are wondering, what about geology? What about the foundation upon which all this is built? At the museum, we respect the law of society, culture, and the law of the jungle, biology. But what about the physical laws? Who is it that stands like Atlas at the foundations of the museum and supports us all by increasing knowledge in geology? It is Ross Pogson, and tonight we honour him as the recipient of the 2020 AMRI Medal. Ross has served the museum with distinction since 1979. He is the collection manager for mineralogy and petrology and the group manager for geosciences and archaeology. Ross manages the 80,000 items in our rock, mineral, meteorite and tektite collection. Ross is a first-rate researcher with nearly 100 publications that demonstrate his expertise in mineralogy, petrology, paleontology, laser Raman spectroscopy, meteoritics, speleology, photomicroscopy, exploration geophysics and archaeology. He is currently working on papers of the Wellington Caves, the Tal Bragar fossil site, and on our ancient Egyptian funerary boat. I expect it will soon be seaworthy. Ross also plays vital roles in public outreach and exhibitions. He has been integral to exhibitions such as Planet of Minerals and to managing our Albert Chapman Collection Galleries. And he has contributed broadly to New South Wales beyond the museum. He assists in training guides for Jenolan Caves, advising on cave environmental and conservation studies, and enhancing the cave visitor experience. He is also a past education officer, librarian, secretary, and vice president of Mineralogical Society New South Wales, and a current member of the Geological Society of Australia and the Australasian Institute of Mining and Metallurgy and the Society of Mineral Museum Professionals and the Australian Cave and Karst Managers Association, just to name a few societies. He regularly gives public lectures to professional and amateur societies and conference presentations, and he supervises university research students in geology. He is also a keen amateur astronomer and photographer, and his interests in geology and physical sciences literally traverse the solar system and beyond. He is also an expert on the construction of sundials, so keep that in mind if you need advice. Ross truly is the atlas that supports our work in the geosciences, an area that is vital to the museum and to Australia, and to the world. And without the 80,000 minerals in our collection and the knowledge of what they do and where to find them, we wouldn't have the digital technology that allows you to log in and join with me in congratulating Ross Pogson here tonight. Congratulations, Ross. If I was asked which mineral you personify, I would say you are pure gold.
Congratulations, Ross Pogson, and thank you, Professor Crosley, for those wonderful words. Before I begin, may I offer on behalf of my fellow Australian Museum trustees and the trustees of the Australian Museum Foundation and the Lizard Island Reef Research Foundations, my sincere thanks to Merlin for your 9 years of service as a trustee to this great institution. Merlin has championed the cause of science and research at the museum. He's been steadfast on the need for a natural history museum to have depth across the branches of science, particularly paleontology. We will miss your wisdom and wit, but you're always very welcome to visit. I'm delighted to be speaking from the Brian Sherman Crystal Hall in the Australian Museum. This newly renovated hall is named after Brian Sherman AM, who was a long-serving president of the Museum Trust and the founding chairman of the Australian Museum Foundation. On behalf of the current trustees, I'd like to thank Brian for his generous support in helping us to transform Australia's first museum into this incredible new space. Of course, our redevelopment would not have been possible without the incredible support of the New South Wales government and our minister, Don Harwin. Thank you for sharing our vision and having the confidence to back us in helping this great institution realise its potential. This newly renovated and expanded museum is a place for future generations to enjoy. And it would not have been possible without our partners and donors who have joined us tonight. It is with your support our inspiring scientists, explorers and educators can continue their groundbreaking work to help us make a better future. Tonight is all about recognising and celebrating the outstanding work of the 2020 Australian Museum Eureka Prize finalists. It's incredibly important that we take the time to publicly recognise and celebrate the great work of scientists and science communicators, because many are often working to solve tough problems, not for themselves, but for the benefit of our society, our country, and indeed the world. Thank you for all your hard work and enjoy receiving the recognition you so thoroughly deserve. I'll hand back to Adam Spencer to commence announcing the next winner of the 2020 Australian Museum Eureka Prizes.
Thank you, David Armstrong, President of the Australian Museum Trust, for those inspiring words. And thank you, Merlin Crossley, for that little detour into New South Wales administrative law. I was worried we wouldn't go there this evening. But as always, Merlin, you delivered the goods. And I'd now like to re-invite Dr. Carl and Professor Ian Young from the University of Sydney to announce the winner of the 2020 University of Sydney Sleek Geeks Science Eureka Prize Secondary Schools category. This prize is awarded for a short film that communicates a scientific concept in an accessible and engaging way, again on the topic of water. Let's take a look at all the finalists.
Amiran Galloway-McLean, St Leonard's College, Victoria.
Viscosity of solutions containing electrically charged polymers dissolved in water. So, why exactly is this relevant to you? Well, one of the places you find a solution that contains charged polymers dissolved in water is in your own body, in something called synovial fluid.
Himalaya Joshi, Baldwin High School, Victoria.
On a flat surface, merging together in a way that's gorgeous.
Have you ever wondered why this happens? Let's ask some people to see what they reckon.
Forces in the water?
Surface tension, maybe?
Surface tension?
Jessica Nipperess and Zachary Nipperess, St Matthew's Catholic School, New South Wales.
Yeah, not all substances.
What about how solids sink in their liquid counterpart?
Yeah, that's not true. What do you know?
This means water doesn't behave properly.
Well.
Wow.
And third place is awarded to Aneerin Galloway McLean.
Second place is awarded to Jessica Nipperus and Zachary Nipperus.
The winner of the 2020 University of Sydney Sleek Geeks Science Eureka Prize Secondary is Himmerly Jossie.
Looking fantastic, Himmerly. Is there someone there who can do the honours, please, and present him with his prize? Dr. Carr, what would you like to ask of our winner?
Well, Dr. Joshi, your effort, the song, is kind of like the tea towel, the perfect blend of function and form. What made you sing about surface tension? Why? What was driving you?
Well, the idea to sing came quite a while ago when I started researching this film initially. I came across this topic when I read a paper in the journal Nature, and I was thinking about how to communicate it quite uniquely, because ever since I conceived the topic for this film, the main idea I had on my mind was to make it as unique as possible. And out of the blue, just popped up in my head, the idea to sing. And so I, even though singing is not my best, I tried, I did 20,000 retakes, and I finally sung it.
And are you going to take this into another version, like Surface Tension on Ice, or are you going to go into a different musical form and a different content for your next effort?
Well, I'm always thinking of what I'm going to do next, so I might make a song, or I might not. I might even try making a remix, or I might not. Nothing's confirmed yet. I will see what I do.
Well, a huge congratulations, Himmerly. I mean, who doesn't read the occasional article in Nature and want to sing about it? And, of course, our runners-up, Aneerin Galloway-McLean and Jessica and Zachary Nipperus. Congratulations to all of you. You'll be receiving prizes from Abby's Bookshop. Thank you, Professor Young and Dr. Carlin. Once again, a big congratulations to all our young Sleek Geek scientists here tonight and in the future. I'd now like to welcome the Honourable Melissa Price MP, Minister for Defence Industry.
Thank you, Adam. Before I announce the Defence Science and Technology Eureka Prize for Safeguarding Australia, I would like to mention how proud I am of the significant contributions made by Australian scientists every day to safeguard our nation, and especially in the challenging environment we find ourselves in this year. More than ever, it is a testament to the importance of science, technology and research to help keep abreast of the challenges our country may face. It gives me great pleasure to be involved in this year's Eureka Prizes, albeit virtually, and I offer my heartfelt congratulations to all finalists and winners from tonight's event.
Thank you, Minister. The 2020 Department of Defence Eureka Prize for Outstanding Science in Safeguarding Australia is awarded for outstanding research that has led to, or is likely to lead to, innovative solutions for Australia's national security. So let's take a look at the finalists.
Professor Benjamin Eggleton, Dr. Eric Maggi, Dr. Moritz Merklein, Dr. Alvaro Casas Bedoya, Dr. Yang Liu, and Associate Professor Stephen Madden, University of Sydney and Australian National University. University of New South Wales Biodefence. Professor Ba Nuvo, Professor Ba Tung Vo, and Dr. Michael Beard, Curtin University and Solonoff Proprietary Limited.
The winner of the Eureka Prize for Outstanding Science in Safeguarding Australia is Professor Benjamin Eckleton, Dr. Eric Maggi, Dr. Moritz Merklein, Dr. Alvaro Casas Bedoya, Dr. Yang Liu from the University of Sydney, okay, and Associate Professor Stephen Madden from the Australian National University. by harnessing the delicate interaction between light and sound, Professor Benjamin Eckleton and his team have produced a microchip that provides a unique advantage for defence platforms. With prototypes already developed in Australia and internationally, this compact technology heralds a new era in microwave signal processing and represents real gains in performance, efficiency, and cost. A very big congratulations to you all.
You were going to jump the gun there, but the minister was busy singing your praises. Congratulations. Say something on behalf of the team.
We just want to acknowledge that it's taken 16 years to get here. We want to acknowledge the Australian Research Council for their tremendous support. Great team here around me. And those that can't join us who are in other parts of the world, and our collaborators that have supported this work, particularly wanted to acknowledge Barry Luther Davies and Duke Joy at ANU, who are also supporting this wonderful research. Thanks very much.
Well, congratulations, Professor Benjamin Eckleton and the team, Dr. Eric Margie, Dr. Moritz Merklein, Dr. Alvaro Casas-Baidoro, Dr. Yang Liu, and Associate Professor Stephen Madden. And thank you so much, Minister Price. And I'd now like Professor Kate McGrath, Deputy Vice-Chancellor and Vice President Research, to rejoin us and announce the winner of the 2020 University of Technology Sydney Eureka Prize for Excellence in Data Science. This prize is awarded for high-impact data science research. But before announcing the winner, let's meet our finalists.
Professor Din Fung, Monash University. Professor Da Sheng Tao, University of Sydney.
The winner of the 2020 University of Technology Sydney Eureka Prize for Excellence in Data Science is Professor Da Sheng To.
Congratulations, Professor To. Well done. Would you like to say a few words?
Thank you very much for this brilliant news. And it's my great honor to receive this distinction. I'd like to thank the Australian Museum organizes this award, the University of Sydney, to build an awesome research environment. My colleagues and students to work with me so hard to conquer the research challenges. My nominators and endorsers to support my nomination. UTS to sponsor this prize, and my family to understand my very busy schedule. These are the main reasons why I'm here today. And finally, in 2015, Eureka Prize ceremony. I mentioned that AI era is coming. 5 years passed. Tonight, I'd like to emphasize that deep learning powered AI will keep rocking. Thank you very much.
Yes, brilliant news for brilliant work. Congratulations, Professor Da Sheng Tao. And thank you, Professor McGrath. Well, now let's rejoin Jonica and Chris. Jonica, the Sleek Geeks is always a popular part of Eureka Prizes night, but this year our school kids went one better. They were all singing, all dancing. What did you think about these wonderful science storytellers?
Yeah, well, I mean, these kids are so talented, they do my head in. I mean, every year, this is such a crowd favourite. And we didn't get to broadcast tonight the full videos, so I hope people do go and check them out if they haven't already online.
Yeah, if you search for Sleek Geek Science Prize online, you'll see all the videos. They were 90 seconds long this year, and the three finalists in both categories, fantastic.
Absolutely brilliant, all of them, and just multi-talented. And we saw that there's, you know, of course, you read a Nature article, you turn it into a song, why don't you? But, you know, if you go back to the primary school winners as well, you'll see that, of course, the phase shift of water from the liquid to the solid was crying out for interpretation through contemporary dance. So...
And was it just me, or was Himalay's mum who presented him with the prize? Might have made a little cameo in his video. That's what I thought I saw there.
I think I saw that too. Everyone has to check those videos out.
Yeah, what jumped out for you, Chris?
Oh, for me, it's a great moment for me to make a dedicated recognition of Ross Pogson, who won our Australian Museum Research Institute medal this year. Ross has been an amazing presence at the museum for decades, and his expertise, his scientific expertise in geology, geochemistry, mineralogy, so many things that you heard about is really part of the scientific glue that holds us all together as the researchers at AMRI. So, Ross Pogson, well done tonight, mate.
Great stuff. A couple more check-ins with what you've been thinking at home. One I noticed earlier, Jackson Ryan said, I'm excited, wishing the best of luck to all the finalists, except Carl Smith. My mortal enemy. Jackson, Carl, I hope you worked that out. Christine says, congratulations to all the finalists. So wonderful to be joining together for this event. Matthew says, everyone's so well-dressed. This event's even better than the Oscars. Well spotted, Matthew. And a final comment from Owen Evans. I love this. As a retired science teacher, I want to congratulate all the past, present and emerging teachers who've unlocked all these creative minds. Thank you so much for joining us. Jonica, great having you here.
Thank you.
Well done on your behind-the-desk debut, Chris. Great to have you here as well.
Thanks, Adam.
Jonica and Chris, thank you so much. It's now my pleasure to welcome to your screens Dr. Kathy Foley, AO. She is the CSIRO Chief Scientist and Australia's Federal Chief Scientist in waiting. I'm getting all fanboy to announce the winner of the 2020 CSIRO Eureka Prize for Leadership in Innovation and Science. This prize is awarded to an individual who successfully integrated their science talents with their management skills necessary to nurture, inspire, and mobilise their peers.
Professor Maria Cavallaris, AM, University of New South Wales and Children's Cancer Institute. Professor Robert F. Park, University of Sydney. Professor Geordie Williamson, University of Sydney.
And the winner of the 2020 CSIRO Eureka Prize for Leadership in Innovation and Science is Professor Robert F. Park. Congratulations, yay!
Congratulations, Professor Park. Would you like to say a few words?
Well, first of all, I'll say I'm stunned, simply stunned. My fellow finalists, Geordie and Maria, doing amazing work, so this is a real privilege. Can I acknowledge the Australian Museum, CSIRO, and the other organisations that are supporting the Eureka Awards? It's an amazing program. We need positive messaging around science more than ever these days, and the Eurekas are just terrific in that regard. I feel very fortunate that I had the support of some wonderful organisations, University of Sydney and the Grains Research and Development Corporation, who have enabled my research over many, many years. And finally, I think I'd just say that to innovate and to lead in science, you need a team. And I've been very, very privileged to lead a team of wonderful people at the Plant Breeding Institute. Thank you.
They're on a little bit of a roll in that room with the red seats at the University of Sydney at the moment, aren't they? Congratulations, Professor Robert F. Park. And thank you so much, Dr. Foley. I would now like to invite the Honourable Dr. Annabel Bennett, Board Chair ANSTO, to announce the winner of the 2020 ANSTO Eureka Prize for Innovative Use of Technology. This prize is awarded for an innovative application of a new or existing technology that has led to a significantly improved research outcome. Let's meet our finalists.
BioNano VR. University of Queensland, University of New South Wales, and Monash University. Adjunct Professor Dennis Delek, Defence Science and Technology Group. Monash Pharmaceutical Milkshake Team, Monash University and ANSTO.
The winner of the 2020 ANSTO Eureka Prize for Innovative Use of Technology is the Monash Pharmaceutical Milkshake Team. Congratulations, that's fabulous. Well done.
Oh, I love a good pharmaceutical milkshake as much as the next person. Congratulations. Who wants to say something on behalf of the team?
Thanks, Carl. It's Ben Boyd here. I'd just like to thank the Australian Museum for supporting science. It's a fantastic night, and congratulations to all the other winners. I'd like to thank my the group, the team that are with me here at Monash, Melinda Salim, Andy Clulow, Gisela Ramirez, and Adrian Hawley can't be with us tonight from the Australian Synchrotron. Lastly, I'd like to thank our supporters, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, Australian Research Council, and last but not certainly not least, ANSTO and the Australian Synchrotron. Thank you.
No trouble at all. Congratulations, Ben. I'll tell Carl you said hi. And congratulations to everyone at the Monash Pharmaceutical Milkshake team. And thank you so much tonight, Dr. Bennett. I'd now like to invite Chris LeBlanc, Managing Director 3M Australia, to announce the winner of the 2020 3M Eureka Prize for Emerging Leader in Science. This prize is awarded to an individual scientist who has used their leadership skills to create impact within their discipline or more broadly.
Associate Professor Asher Bowen, Wesfarmers Centre of Vaccines and Infectious Diseases, Telethon Kids Institute. Associate Professor Sumit Walia, RMIT University. Dr. Zhizha Zhao, University of Technology, Sydney.
Very exciting. I have the envelope here. So the winner of the 2020 3M Eureka Prize for Emerging Leader in Science is Associate Professor Asha Bowen. Big congratulations, Asha.
Congratulations, Professor Bowen. What would you like to say?
Well, thank you very much. Thank you very much for the honour of being named the 3M Eureka Emerging Leader in Science in 2020. I also just want to congratulate the two finalists with me. That it's such an honour to be part of this tonight. Thank my husband, my children and my team at the Telethon Kids Institute and Wesfarmers Centre for Vaccines and Infectious Diseases for the incredible support that they provide, which makes this achievement possible. But more importantly, I'd like to acknowledge that I have the privilege of living and working on Noongarrbuddja, Yawuru, Gulitja, Wurundjeri, Gidja, Gurrujeri, Bardi and Nyulnyul country. I pay respects to elders, the traditional custodians of the land that we get to work with. Over the last decade, I, along with a great research team, have been privileged to work closely with Aboriginal elders, communities, families and kids in the pursuit of healthy skin for all. Remote living Aboriginal children have the highest rate of skin infections in the world, an unacceptable fact in our country, and our research team are well on the way to reducing this. So I really feel that this award recognises the challenges which our First Nations people continue to navigate and the incredible strength, generosity, courage, and grace our partnership has in addressing these vitally important issues. And I can celebrate this year, the year of COVID, as an infectious diseases specialist, how magnificent it is that Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander Australians have completely reversed the gap for COVID-19. And to date, no one has died from that population. That is the leadership and the opportunity we need to embrace and take the long walk together on this land that has always been, though, that of the First Nations. Thank you very much.
Well, the future of Australian science is in safe hands with emerging scientists of that quality. Congratulations to our two finalists and Associate Professor Asher Bowen, the winner in that category. And thank you so much, Chris LeBlanc, for joining us this evening. Well, here we are in the engine room of tonight's award ceremony. This is where all the Eureka Prizes magic happens. How are we going, guys? Don't know about you at home, but just standing here, I can sense the power. Talking about power, back to you, Kim, for your final remarks.
Thank you, Adam. You're just great. And I would like to offer my heartfelt thanks to you for your brilliant hosting, as usual, as MC for this evening. And to all those behind the scenes tonight who've made this night possible, from our producers, Fourth Wall Events, Jeremy Garling and his team, and our commentators in the studio, Jonica Newby and Professor Chris Helgen. I'd also like to thank our 74 judges who took some 400 hours to sift through literally hundreds of entries from every state and territory before settling on the 51 finalists. Without their unending support, the Eureka Prizes would not be possible. Thank you all. And to my Eureka Prizes team at the Australian Museum, James Lotherington, Cara Bevington and Kate Smith, thank you so much. And of course, I will not conclude this evening without offering one last congratulations to all our winners tonight, all the nominees and prize partners and program supporters who made the Eureka Prizes and this award ceremony possible. And from the Australian Museum Hinsey Hall, where I hope you'll all come and visit us soon, because now we're free. And back to you, Adam.
Well, that, everyone, concludes the Eureka Prizes for 2020. Thank you, Kim, and for those joining us from around the world, including Germany and Greece. Now, I'll admit, the set does have a bit of a Sky News vibe. I can't wait to get the gang back together sometime next year and bring you hard-hitting news and opinion. Thank you all for joining us this evening. The Eureka Prizes will be back in 2021. And I'd like to invite back to the virtual stage all the winners of the 2020 Australian Museum Eureka Prizes. Please join me in giving them one final round of applause. Congratulations. Well done, one and all. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for joining us this evening. In the spirit of Australian science, good night.